It's really important when you're getting ready for auditions to get away from the excerpts and play, whether it be etudes or solos, just get away from it and play music. And listen to any kind of music. Any, it doesn't have to always be classical, and definitely not always tuba or brass. You know, listen outside. You know, have a broad musical diet. And that way, the more you are what you eat kind of thing, the more you are what you listen to too. So just, even if it's just some sort of techno beat, or whatever, it just, it's like, okay, man, that's just like, time just keeps moving. Maybe you can use that in something, maybe Meister Singer. Boom, 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 whatever. So just be willing to get away from the excerpts, because if you do that, you're going to be stunted musically. I'm sure you're not, but you're showing me that you've got some music, so. This sounds good. Be careful with the A flats, da. When you hit them, the pitch is kind of wah, especially when they come in the second time. So be aware of that. And another thing is for when you're playing this for an audition committee, it takes a little bit for you to really kind of establish your tempo. Because those first two notes, da, 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 that's when you really kind of start to feel the time from behind the screen, for them to be able to tell what tempo you're doing. And once you get that, you got to stick to it. It's easy to, for those da, 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 those D's want to come in just a little bit late. Da, de, ba 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 da dee, da 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 da. Yeah. So, and that's where making sure that you don't go ba ba ba. So you ba dee, ba ba ba. So take a longer breath so that you are exactly right on time. And that goes with playing in ensembles as well. Making sure if you have a few beat rests, one ba or off beat ba ba ba. You don't want to go ba ba ba. So because if you're doing that, you're going to be late, and the conductor, you're going to give the conductor a reason to tell you you're late. They're looking for a reason, and don't make it easy on them. So that's always kind of a fun thing to do, to see how long you can go before a conductor says you're late. As a tuba player, a little brass player, say see how long you can balance that. But anyway, so would you play this again? Okay. This is my work. Technical difficulties. Is it on?
Yes.
Okay. Now, actually, let me just play some of this. So those A flats. How do you keep the intensity? Some people use vibrato on these. Other people, you just try to, just keep it moving. And you're doing a pretty good job of that. Let me just see. I tend to use a little bit of vibrato, but I go back and forth. I'm not committed. A little bit of diaphragm vibrato. You really I don't know if you ever worked on that sort of vibrato at all. Or
I've used a lot of that.
More jaw. You know, I kind of use a combination of the two. For that, it's mostly diaphragm, like a singer, you know. But you don't have to, you don't have to use vibrato. You can keep that intensity, you can have that same intensity without vibrato. You don't want to make it too, you know, like Broadway. I was like, I'm a bear. would you mind trying it again? And with regards to the accents, beep 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 beep, da 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 dee da 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 da. A little bit of a, kind of a breathy accent, especially on those. You know, there's the phrasing mark, the slur mark, dee da 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 dee da 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 da. A little bit of air accent on those. Give it a shot. Once you set that up, once you come in on that second note, you have more of a sense of time and what's going on. It seems like that dotted hat is just a little bit. That's just nitpicking. So when you get those other ones with that accent on them, I'm hearing a bah, bah. Make sure you have complete control. You know, I think it might be that your tongue is just kah. You're putting a little bit too much air behind the tongue. You know, and it's just too much compression there. So your embouchure is responding, going rah, right? Mm. So can you try to just think more of an air accent, mm-hmm. and just let the tongue release the note?
Okay.
Release the air. Okay. You try. You can just. Go ahead and play. You don't just play the top line. Just one of those A flights, just accent them with no tongue, just air. Some long tones just to make sure you're steady up there, and maybe you're a little tired, maybe you're a little nervous, I don't know, but yeah, just to make sure that you keep an even tone there. And with regards to those other accents where I was talking about, I'm using a tongue, but I'm not going ta ta ta. It's still connected. Ha ta ta ha da da. The voice doesn't stop, right? I'm not going ha ta ta, right? So, and that same goes when you know. Yeah, it just keeps it moving. Would you try that opening line one more time? Feel like you're doing a lot. It's one of those things that if you're not used to doing something like that, it might feel like you're doing a lot, but it's not. So, and I think that's really one of those kind of things, like, I'm not used to that, so you can't really hear it from out here. You're feeling it, but we're not hearing it. So record yourself, and you know, you just really need to feel like you're exaggerating a lot until you get used to it, and then it'll just become a natural thing. Yeah, and just remember that those with that A flat to the D, if you get to where you can get that without you know cracking out on the horn, but really use that crescendo to your advantage. You're a bear, man. And then those D's really drive those to the 16th note. Anyway, yeah, so yeah, if you just keep that in mind, that'll be cool.